How to lay a deck. A timber deck can offer the perfect outdoor space, providing a seamless link between the home and garden, and helping to bring the outside in. Whether you just want to relax in the sun, entertain guests, or you need an attractive feature to break up a large expanse of lawn, decking could be the answer. You'll find a full list of tools and materials you'll need at the end of this video. The key to a successful deck is in the planning. First, you need to decide on the location. Do you want a sunny or shaded location, and is privacy a requirement? If you choose a permanently shady spot, be prepared to clean and treat the wood annually to preserve the timber from damp and prevent algae growth. It's best to avoid very wet areas completely. You'll start by planning your deck to scale on paper. Try to be as accurate as possible, bearing in mind it's the deck boarding that governs the size of the deck. Designing a deck carefully will limit cutting and wastage and will help you to be accurate when ordering the number of boards and structural treated joists you need. If you're planning to add fascia boards to your deck, then remember to factor in their 28mm width into your plans. We would also advise that you plan your deck to fit only whole deck boards, to avoid having to cut a deck board lengthways to fill a gap. Also, when planning, bear in mind that if you're building your decking next to a house, as we are, then make sure it's 150mm below the damp-proof course, and that you don't cover any air bricks. An existing patio or concrete base can be used as a solid foundation for a deck of any shape or size. However, if you're laying the deck over lawn, then dig out to a depth of 50mm and cover the ground with Wickes Landscaping Fabric. You should also add gravel to the fabric to help hold it in place and to further prevent weed growth. On especially soft ground, it's a good idea to use paving slabs bedded on gravel as a simple foundation to support the deck and preserve timber. If the decking will be joining onto a house, as ours is, then the first thing to do is to attach the wall plate to the wall. To do this, start by marking a vertical line that ultimately the end of your joist will be placed against. This will mark the corner of your decking. If you need to plan around a step or a sill, then take an offcut of deck board and hold it up to the lowest part of the sill and draw a line underneath. Then, using a spirit level, draw a level line 10mm lower than your first line to allow for expansion. This line will be your guideline for attaching the wall plate to the wall. Now cut the joist to length. If you do need to avoid any obstacles, such as a pipe, then measure and cut the joist accordingly. Once you have cut the joist that will form your wall plate to length, measure 100mm in from one end and mark the wood. Using a set square to ensure a straight line, draw a vertical line down from your mark. Measure 50mm down from the top of the line and 50mm up from the bottom and mark the wood. This is where you will eventually drill your pilot holes. Repeat this process at 600mm intervals down the length of the wall plate. When you reach the far end of the wood, measure and mark out another 100mm section, as it's best to have 100mm sections at each end to ensure stability. Take your drill and 8mm wood drill bit and drill the pilot holes. Once this is done, treat all the holes and cut ends of wood with 2 coats of preservative to ensure the timber remains structurally sound for as long as possible. You should repeat this for all holes and cut ends whilst building your decking. Be sure to follow manufacturer's instructions on drying and safety. Put the wall plate into position in line with your guideline on the wall. You could either ask for a helping hand to hold it in place, or use packers to support the plank whilst you check that it's level. Before securing the wall plate to the house, double check that the deck board fits beneath the sill. Once you're happy with the positioning of your wall plate, you can drill guide holes into the wall using a 7mm masonry drill bit. It's best to ask someone to hold the wood in place for you whilst you drill your guide holes. Then, move the wall plate away and complete the holes by drilling directly into the wall. Take the wall plugs and insert them into the holes you've drilled. Then move the wall plate back into position, making sure it's still in line with your original corner mark on the wall. Insert 130mm screws through the holes in the wall plate and hang galvanised or plastic washers on the end. You should use enough washers to ensure 10mm of distance between the wall and the wall plate. This will stop water from becoming trapped between the house and the decking. You can then hand tighten the screws into the wall plugs before using a drill and driver bit to secure them. If there's an obstacle, like our drain, then repeat this process to attach the second plate to the wall. Now your wall plate is in position, it's time to build the outer frame of your decking using the decking bearers. To ensure rainwater runs off your deck and away from the house, you need to allow for a slight fall in the level of the deck frame. You should factor in a 2mm fall for every metre. Bear in mind this fall when checking the levels throughout the build. If, like us, the deck you're planning to build is longer than your decking bearers, then you'll need to extend the bearer by joining two sections together. To do this, measure out and cut the two lengths of bearer that you need to reach the required length. Then, measure out a 600mm section. Before sawing this section, it's helpful to draw a small line at 300mm to show where the middle of the section is. This will help you to line it up where the bearers join. Place the sections into your workbench and secure with clamps, making sure the 300mm mark lines up with the join of the bearers. You may need two workbenches or an extra pair of hands to support the overhanging wood. Next, measure 75mm and 150mm from the join on both sides and mark the wood. From each of the four marks, use a set square to draw a straight line. On each of the lines, measure out and mark two evenly spaced points. This is where you'll drill your pilot holes. Once the eight marks are in place, drill pilot holes using the 5mm wood drill bit. If you're going to be using fascia boards, then you should also countersink the screws so that the fascia can sit flush to the bearer. Then secure with 100mm screws. You can now measure out, cut, and repeat the joining process for the remaining side of the frame. Next, put your bearers into position, and where possible, put the joins at the end where there will be least through traffic. It's important to get the bearers to the required level before fixing together. So place risers, paving slabs, or treated offcuts of timber at 500mm intervals, then check the level. Before fixing, you should also check the corners are square using a set square. Mark and drill pilot holes before using two external grade 150mm screws to join the frame at each corner. If you can't access a corner of the decking, then you can secure the bearers by drilling skewed pilot holes at a 45 degree angle into the wood and securing with 100mm screws. Once the frame is secure, double check that it's at the required level and make small adjustments if necessary. If you're using offcuts of timber, then make sure it's treated. Decking can be laid in a variety of different patterns. Here's a few examples. To work out how many internal bearers you need to prepare, you should start by measuring 400mm from the centre of the external bearer and drawing a mark. Then, measure from the mark you made and repeat this at 400mm intervals across the rest of the bearer. If the measurements leave you with a gap of over 400mm at the end, then add an extra support, as it's important not to exceed 400mm spacing. Once you know how many internal joists you need, you can measure and cut accordingly. If you're extending your joists, as we are, then repeat the same process as last time, but with the addition of an extra 600mm section on the opposite side to sandwich the joist in place. This will add additional support to the deck. When doing this, make sure you offset the bolts slightly so they don't come into contact. Now that the joists are prepared, it's time to attach your joist hangers. To do this, secure the joist in your workbench and attach the joist hangers using 30mm exterior screws. To secure the joist to the frame, place it into position with the centre of the joist lining up with the 400mm spacer mark. You need to be sure that the joist is flush with the exterior frame, so either have someone hold it for you or use packers to keep it in place. Use a set square to extend your 400mm guide marker down onto the external face. From this line, measure up 40mm from the bottom and down 40mm from the top and make two marks. Drill your pilot holes using an 8mm wood drill bit, followed by countersink holes using the countersink drill bit. Secure with 100mm external grade screws. Repeat this for the rest of the joists, but make sure the top of the joist is flush with the frame before securing. If, like us, you have to secure the joist onto an unexposed side of the frame, then drill two skewed pilot holes on each side before securing with screws. Once the joists are in place, you can add the final 30mm screws to each joist hanger. Now it's time to measure out and prepare your noggins. You'll need enough to never exceed a distance of more than 1200mm between noggins. It's also easiest to stagger your noggins, so that you don't have to skew screws to attach them. So bear this in mind when planning where they'll be positioned. To attach them, put the noggin into position and add packers if necessary. Then, start by drawing a line down the centre of the noggin's position on both of the joists it will join to. Measure and mark 40mm from the bottom and 40mm from the top on each side. Next, drill your pilot holes before securing the noggin with 100mm external screws. If you have an obstacle, like we do, then make sure you add extra noggins around it for additional support. Once all the noggins are in place, do your final levelling and ensure the joists are all supported at 500mm intervals. Now you've completed building your frame and are ready to lay the deck board on top of it. If the deck boards will fit perfectly on your decking without having to trim any down, then start laying them by the house. However, if you need to cut a board lengthways, then do it either with a handsaw or circular saw and place the cut board at the area of least through traffic. Ours is placed by the house, so we need to start laying our boards at the opposite end. We're going to be attaching a fascia board to the decking, so need to allow for an overhang in the board. It's a good idea to pre-drill all fixing points with a 2mm bit to prevent boards from splitting. And if you countersink all drilled fixing points, you'll get a smoother finish, especially at the board ends. Now, fix a 64mm decking screw into the second groove, securing the deck board to the joist beneath. Repeat this process at the opposite end. This will ensure your board is straight. You can now fix the rest of the screws. Because this board is overhanging, screw through the third groove of the outside edge to ensure it's comfortably secured to the joist. When fixing the rest of the boards, always use the second groove in from either side. Make sure to keep spaces even between adjacent boards. Because timber expands and contracts with the changing weather, you should include a gap of between 5mm and 8mm between each board. Create a suitably sized spacer from an offcut of timber and use it to check the gap between boards is equal all the way along. If you need to cut a deck board to accommodate an obstacle, then mark out on your wood and cut with a jigsaw. Or you could create a template to mark your wood accurately. When laying the board next to the house, make sure it's 10mm away from the wall. If you're adding fascia boards to your deck, then measure and cut all the pieces you need. Bear in mind that you should keep a gap of between 5 and 8mm between all boards to allow for expansion. Mark the wood with a line at 50mm from each end. Then, measure out and mark lines at 600mm intervals. Place small offcuts or packers underneath the fascia to level before pre-drilling guide holes in the second groove in from each side. Finally, secure the fascias with 64mm decking screws. You can now sit back and admire your work from your brand new deck. Here's the list of tools you'll need to build your deck. and here are the materials you'll use. And this is the recommended safety equipment needed.